Hello students, welcome back to online classes. In last video we discussed about the physical properties of a group 2 elements, that is alkaline earth metals. In this video we will discuss about the chemical reactivity of a alkaline earth metals, means the group 2 elements. So these are showing less reactivity compared to alkali metals. So these are also reactive, but whenever we are comparing with the group 1 elements alkali earth metals, these are less reactive towards the some of the chemical compounds. So that's why these are also showing the reactivity towards air, halogens, hydrogen and liquid ammonia, and these are also behaving as a good reducing agents. So in that, first one is the reactivity towards air and water. The reactivity towards air and water. So the magnesium and beryllium, so these are kinetically inert in nature. So as a result of that, other alkaline earth metals are showing the more vigorous reaction towards the air as well as the water. The beryllium and magnesium, so Be and Mg. So beryllium and magnesium are kinetically inert. So kinetically inert means they are having high activation energy for the product formation. So those are said to be the kinetically inert molecules. The activation energy for these molecules should be high for the product formation. So that's why those are said to be kinetically inert. So beryllium, it should forms the powder form of beryllium should forms the barium oxide and barium nitride whenever it should exposes to atmospheric air. In this atmospheric air, presence of nitrogen is also there, so that is why they should form their corresponding oxides as well as nitrates. So beryllium, it is exposes to air, it form beryllium oxide and beryllium nitride. And magnesium is also shows the dazzling brilliance formation of a magnesium oxide as well as the magnesium nitride. So all the alkaline earth metals will form their monooxides and nitrates, M3N2, in the form of M3N2 they should form nitrates and they should form monooxides. Metal monooxide means only one oxide is combined with the metal. So in this way, these are showing the reactivity towards air. So firstly, the beryllium and magnesium are kinetically inert. Beryllium and magnesium are kinetically inert. Next is oxygen and water. Second point is the powdered form. Powdered beryllium burns brilliantly. The powder beryllium burns brilliantly on ignition in air. Ignition in air, it gives barium oxide and beryllium nitride. Air gives beryllium oxide and beryllium nitride. And similarly, The magnesium also burns with air. The magnesium is also burns dazzling brilliance and gives the magnesium oxide and magnesium nitride and other compounds like calcium, strontium and barium. So these are also showing reactivity towards air and water. They should form their corresponding oxides as well as the nitrates, and when they react with the water they should form their hydroxide. So these calcium, strontium and barium, those are also reactivity, they are also showing reactivity towards the cold water and soluble in the water. So except beryllium and magnesium, so these two does not react with the cold water, but calcium, strontium and barium, see these are showing the reactivity towards the cold water. The calcium, strontium and barium are strongly attacked with air. They form corresponding their oxides and nitrates. And these three, they also react with cold water to form, forms their hydroxides. Okay, so these are the reactivity towards air and water. So the beryllium and magnesium are kinetically inert, and the powdered beryllium burns brilliantly on ignition in air to give barium oxide and barium nitride. The magnesium, it burns with dazzling brilliance in air and gives the magnesium oxide and magnesium nitride. And the calcium, strontium, barium, so these are strongly attacked with the air, or else they are showing strong reaction with air and form their oxides and nitrates. But these three elements also show vigorous reaction with the cold water and form their hydroxide. But beryllium and magnesium does not react with the cold water. So this is about the reactivity towards air and water. So next is the reactivity towards the halogens. The next chemical reactivity is reactivity towards the halogens. So these alkaline earth metals react with halogens and form the corresponding halides. Halogens are nothing but fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So whenever the alkaline earth metals react with the halogens, they should form the metal halides here, alkaline earth metal halides. But we can prepare the barium fluoride due to the dissociation of diammonium tetrafluorobarium. So we can prepare all the halides except beryllium. We can directly prepare the metal halides, but we can prepare beryllium fluoride by the dissociation of diammonium beryllium tetrafluorine compound. So in this way we are going to get the formation of halogens here. So I will write the general equation. So whenever the alkaline earth metal combines with the halogens, it will form the metal halides here. So those are alkaline earth metals, where X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Okay, but we will prepare barium fluoride after the dissociation of diammonium beryllium tetrafluorine compound. So after the dissociation of diammonium beryllium compound, it will gives the beryllium fluoride. So this is the method for the preparation of beryllium fluoride here. And the beryllium chloride is also made from the beryllium oxide. So we can prepare beryllium chloride by burning beryllium oxide in presence of hot coke with chlorine at 600 to 800 kelvins of temperature. You will get the formation of a beryllium chloride with the liberation of carbon monoxide. Now and however, it is the reversible reaction. So after the combining with carbon monoxide, again we will get the formation of a barium oxide here. So that's why the thermal decomposition, or as a dissociation, thermal decomposition will give the formation of beryllium fluoride. And upon treating beryllium oxide with chlorine gas in presence of hot coke, we are going to get the formation of a beryllium chloride here. But apart from this beryllium, all the metal alkaline earth metals are showing direct reaction with halogens, and they form their corresponding metal halides like fluorides, chlorides, bromides and iodides. So in this way, these are showing reactivity towards the halogen. So next is the reaction with hydrogen. So all the alkaline earth metals are combines with hydrogen and they form their hydrides. So when they react with halogen, that is said to be halides. When they react with hydrogen, they form hydrides. Okay, hydrogen except beryllium. Here also beryllium, it is not showing the direct reaction with hydrogen, but we can prepare the beryllium hydride upon treating with the reducing agents like a lithium aluminium hydrides. So by treating beryllium chlorides with lithium aluminium hydrogen, we can able to prepare the beryllium hydrides. But apart from beryllium, all the alkaline earth metals are showing more reactivity towards the hydrogen and they form their corresponding hydrides. So all the alkaline earth metals except beryllium, all the elements means group 2 elements, all the group 2 elements directly combines with hydrogen and form their hydrides. And form their hydrides, that is MH2. So MH2 is metal hydrides, MX2 is metal halides. Okay, hydrides and halides. If X is there, then those are said to be halides. If H is there, it is hydride. Upon heating. So at the increased temperature, we are able to get the formation of a metal hydrides except beryllium. Beryllium, Be. But we will prepare the beryllium hydride by treating beryllium chloride with lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride, it will form barium hydride with the liberation of lithium chloride and aluminium trichloride, AlCl3. We can prepare the beryllium hydride by treating beryllium chloride with lithium aluminium hydride. They should form the beryllium hydride with the liberation of lithium chloride and aluminium trichloride. So in this way, these are showing reactivity towards the hydrogen. So except beryllium, all the elements show reaction with hydrogen upon heating. We will get the formation of their corresponding metal hydrides. If it is calcium, they should form calcium hydride. If it is barium, they should form barium hydride. Strontium with hydrogen, it will forms the strontium hydride. So in this way, they will combines with the hydrogen. So the fourth chemical property is the chemical reactivity towards the acids. So all the alkaline earth metals react with the acid, they form their chlorides and hydrogen liberation will be taken place. If hydrogen chloride is acid, means HCl is acid, then they should form metal chlorides with the liberation of hydrogen. If we are taking sulfuric acid, they should form their corresponding hydroxides. If the acid is nitric acid, then they should form their nitrates with the liberation of corresponding elements. So that's why the alkaline earth metals, they are also showing reactivity towards the acids. The reactivity towards the acids. Here acids may be HCl or also sulfuric acids. So when alkaline metals react with the hydrochloric acid, they form metal chlorides with the liberation of dihydrogen. So in this way, these are showing readily reaction with the acid and liberate the dihydrogen. So this is about the reactivity towards hydrogen and acids. So the fifth property is the reducing nature of alkaline earth metals. So alkali metals behave as a good reducing agent, and here also the alkaline earth metals are also behaving as a good reducing agent, but compared to alkali metals, these are showing lesser property. Means alkali metals are better reducing agents than that of the alkaline earth metals. So this will exhibit the reducing property due to having large negative reduction potential. So as a result of that, we are using alkaline earth metals as a reducing agent. But when we compared with the alkali metals like sodium, potassium, so those are behaving as a good reducing agent, lithium also. So the lithium is most reducing agent. So here also the beryllium will behave as a good reducing agent, because the beryllium has the more hydration energy as well as it has the smaller size. Because of that, it will be acting as a good reducing agent compared to other alkaline earth metals. Like alkali metals, the alkaline earth metals also behave as strong reducing agents. These are acting as strong reducing agents because they are having large negative reduction potential. So due to this, these are behaving as a reducing agents. Due to large negative value on their reduction potential and however the beryllium has less negative reduction potential compared to other alkaline metals and its reducing nature means beryllium is showing reducing nature. It is mainly due to I'm showing reducing nature. It's due to its smaller size and large hydration energy and it is also having large atomization enthalpy. So it is also having large atomization enthalpy. Atomization enthalpy is nothing but the energy, amount of energy which is required to atomize the molecule. So that is said to be atomization enthalpy. So these are alkaline earth metals are showing reducing property due to presence of large negative values on their reduction potential. But beryllium is having the lesser reduction potential. Again, it will behaving as a the reducing agent. Even though it has the smaller negative reduction potential, it is behaving as a reducing agent because of its large hydration energy and large atomization enthalpy due to its small size. It will be behaving as a reducing agent. So we can call reducing agent when they have the larger negative reduction potential. But beryllium is also acting as a reducing agent due to its small size, large hydration energy and large atomization enthalpy. So due to this reason, these alkaline earth metals are acting as a reducing agents like alkali metals. The last chemical property is the solutions in liquid ammonia. So similar to alkali metals, so these are also form the deep blue color whenever they dissolves in the liquid ammonia. So when the alkaline earth metals dissolves in the liquid ammonia, they should give the deep blue color. So again, they should form the ammoniated ions here, and from this solution the ammoniated ammonates can be recovered. So somewhat these are showing similar property to that of the alkali metals only. Liquid ammonia. So when metals are dissolved in ammonia, they should give the deep blue color like alkali metals and form ammoniated ions and ammoniated electrons. These are also giving the deep blue color after alkaline earth metals when dissolves in liquid ammonia they give deep blue color. So almost same reaction which is exhibited by the alkali metals here. So these are the chemical reactivity of alkaline earth metals. So these are showing reactivity towards oxygen and water except beryllium and magnesium, means they will not react with the cold water. So firstly the reactivity towards air and water, secondly the reactivity towards halogen, thirdly the reactivity towards hydrogen, and fifth one is the reactivity towards the acid, and sixth one is the reducing nature of alkaline earth metal, and the last chemical reactivity is the solutions in liquid ammonia. So these are the chemical reactivity which is exhibited by the alkaline earth metals. Next is the general characteristics of the compounds of the alkaline earth metals. So the alkaline earth metals will form compounds in divalent form, that is M+2, and these are ionic in nature. The compounds of these alkaline earth metals are ionic in nature, but it is less ionic when we compared with the alkali metals. It is due to increasing in nuclear charge with their increased atomic size. As the atomic number increases, the nuclear charges increases. So all the alkaline earth metal compounds will be formed compounds in the divalent form, that is M+2. So in that, the first compounds of alkaline earth metals are the oxides and hydroxides. So already we know that the oxides will form when the alkaline earth metals are showing reaction with the air, they form the monoxides, and all are ionic in nature except the beryllium oxide. The beryllium oxide will exhibit the covalent character, means it is covalent in nature. Other alkaline earth metals are showing ionic nature. The beryllium oxide, it is forms the rock salt structure and it is having the covalent property. But other alkaline earth metals are showing ionic nature, and all the oxides are having the ionic nature, and when they dissolve in water they form their corresponding hydroxide, and all the alkaline earth metals are behave as a strong bases, or else they are showing the basic property when they dissolve in water after they form hydroxide. So they will be behave as a bases. But beryllium oxide will shows the amphoteric nature, means it will be behave as a acid as well as the base here. But other alkaline earth metals are behaving only as a bases, but beryllium oxide will be behave as a acid as well as the base. So that's why it is said to be amphoteric. So amphoteric is nothing but the element, it will exhibit both acidic property and a basic property. So that should be being with the beryllium oxide here. So alkaline earth metals burns in oxygen, they should form their oxides and nitrates. Alkaline earth metals, burns with oxygen or air, they form their monoxide. They forms their monoxides, that is MO. Okay, all are ionic in nature, but beryllium oxide is covalent in nature. All alkaline earth metals are ionic in nature. In nature, except beryllium. Beryllium. It is covalent. Okay. It is covalent in nature. Covalent in nature. And these alkaline earth metals are stable to heat, as well as these are also showing conductivity property. These compounds are stable to heat. Stable to heat, and they react with water, they form their hydroxides. So generally we can write it as MO, the metal oxides. When they react with the water, they form corresponding hydroxides, MOH twice. But beryllium and magnesium, they will not show the reaction with the cold water, except beryllium here. Okay, calcium, barium and strontium showing the reaction with cold water. All the oxides are behave as a basis, or is showing basic in nature, basis, when they react with water. Okay, when they react with water, and form their sparingly soluble hydroxides. But beryllium oxide will be showing the amphoteric nature. I will write here the beryllium oxide, BeO, is showing the amphoteric property. Oxide is amphoteric in nature. Amphoteric in nature means it is showing both acidic property as well as the basic property. Amphoteric in nature, and the solubility and thermal stability towards the heat is increases with increase in atomic number. Means the calcium is showing more stability, and compared to calcium, the strontium is more stable one, and again the barium is more stable compared to other alkaline earth metals. The solubility, the thermal stability and the basic character of these hydroxides increases with increase in atomic number. The beryllium oxide is amphoteric in nature. Toric in nature means both acid and base character. Okay, it will be act as some both acid as well as the acid here, and the solubility and thermal stability thermal stability and basic character increases with increase in atomic number. Okay, so this is about the characters of oxides and hydroxides. We have to remember all the oxides of alkaline earth metals are ionic in nature, but beryllium is showing covalent nature and it has the rock salt structure, and arteric nature means it will behave as a acid as well as the bases here, and these are stable to heat and soluble in water. The solubility, thermal stability and basic character of these alkaline earth metals will be increases with increase in atomic number. So this is about the characteristics of compounds of so next is the general characteristics of halides. So these halides are also ionic in nature except beryllium. So here also the beryllium will forms, or beryllium shows covalent character when they form their corresponding halides, but except beryllium all are showing the ionic in nature. So means the beryllium chloride, it is existent dimeric form. Except beryllium means Be, all alkaline halides of alkaline earth metals are ionic in nature. Beryllium is showing predominantly covalent nature, and beryllium chloride means beryllium chloride, it is form dimer. So beryllium halides are covalent in nature. So due to its covalent property, so these are soluble in organic solvents. So because of having covalent character, the beryllium will be having capacity to soluble in organic solvent, but other alkaline earth metals, due to their ionic nature, they are easily soluble in water. Covalent in nature and soluble in organic solvents. So if you see the dimeric structure of beryllium chloride, it will be like this. So this kind of structure is said to be the dimeric structure, but this dimer will undergo dissociation at a increased temperature of about 12,000 degree centigrade, it form their corresponding monomer. So this dimer should undergo dissociation at 1200 degrees of temperature and forms 1200 kelvins of temperature and form monomer, means beryllium chloride. Okay, so it is having a dimeric structure and soluble in organic solvent, so it form monomer at a 1200 Kelvin temperature, and the tendency to form hydrates the gradually increases from the tendency to form hydrates gradually decreases down the group, means from magnesium to barium it should be decreases, means the magnesium will forms the more hydrated salts compared to calcium and barium and strontium. So down the group it should be decreases. Drop here, we'll show. So in vapor phase it should be exist in dimeric form. The barium chloride in vapor phase it forms the dimeric structure after thermal decomposition at 1200 kelvins of temperature it should form monomer. But the tendency of these hydrated is decreases down the group. The tendency to form halide, the tendency to form halide hydrates is gradually decreases. So remember, decreases down the group. Okay, means the magnesium will easily form hydrated salts. Magnesium chloride 8S2O and calcium is less hydrated, so calcium 6S2O. So hydration properties more in case of magnesium, and strontium chloride is also form their hydrates and etc. So in this way it should be decreases down the group. The dehydration of, we can remove the water molecule from these halides after the dehydration. So after dehydration we will get the corresponding chloride, chloride and bromides. The dehydration of these will give means dehydration means after removal of water molecule from magnesium chloride hydrate it will give only the magnesium chloride. So if you remove the water molecule from calcium hydrated complex we will get only the calcium chloride, and completely we have to remove the water molecule from the compounds, so that is said to be dehydration. So if calcium chloride is present then we will get calcium chloride only. If it is barium fluoride we will get barium fluoride. So in this way the dehydration of the will gives the corresponding fluorides, chlorides, bromides and iodides. In this way we will study the characteristics of the halides here, and if you see the solubility property, the fluorides are less soluble than that of the chlorides. So the fluorides are less soluble in water compared to chlorides due to their high lattice energy. Fluorides are less soluble than the chlorides due to their high lattice energy. Due to means chlorides are having high lattice energy. So these are the characteristics of halide compounds. So halides will form after treating with alkaline earth metal. So those are ionic in nature except beryllium. So beryllium is covalent in nature and it is soluble in organic solvent. In vapor phase of beryllium chloride, it is exist in the dimeric form. So upon thermal decomposition at 1200 Kelvin, it should form its monomer and color should be decreases down the group. As a result, the magnesium chloride is more hydrated compared to others one, and these halides will undergo dehydration. After dehydration, they should form their corresponding fluoride chloride, and bromides are iodides, and the fluorides are less soluble than that of the chlorides because of their high lattice energy or else enthalpy. So these are the characteristics of
the source of abscesses. So these are exhibits in three types: alkaline, alkaline carbonates, sulfates and nitrates. So these carbonates are insoluble in water and this can be precipitated by the addition of sodium or ammonium carbonates, and this insolubility decreases with increase in atomic number. And next, according to sulfates, the barium sulfates and magnesium sulfates are more soluble in water and this solubility is also decreases with increase in atomic number. So sulfates are also showing the same hydration enthalpy phenomena. And nitrates, so these nitrates can be formed by dissolving carbonates in the corresponding dilute nitric acids. The carbonates of alkaline earth metals, when we dissolve in the dilute nitric acids, we will get the nitrates of alkaline earth metals, and they should undergo thermal decomposition. As a result of that, we will get the corresponding metal oxides with the liberation of nitric acid, nitrogen dioxide and the oxygen. And the magnesium nitrate is crystallizes with the 6 water molecules, and whereas the barium nitrate is crystallizes as a anhydride salt. So this is also showing the with increase in atomic number, the dehydration property or also hydration property should be decreases, means hydration enthalpy is decreases with increase in atomic number. So this is about the salts of observed acids. So in next video we will discuss about the further. Thank you.